Following the couple's 2017 divorce, Depp was accused of being a wife abuser by a British tabloid, and the two engaged in a court battle on July 2020 at the High Court in London. As Depp been sentenced to 2 years in prison? Here is the truth. On April 2018, Depp filed a libel lawsuit against the Sun tabloid, citing Heard's earlier allegations of 14 distinct instances of abuse. Their case has been all over, so almost everyone is familiar with what I am talking about. The actor has repeatedly disputed Heard's accusations, but when she was deposed in a libel action on July 2020, she went into considerable detail about the emotional, verbal, and physical abuse she claims she endured during their marriage. "He referred to me as a harlot. I said if I tried to wear anything that could be considered as sexy, I was labeled as a slut, fame-hungry, and an attention whore. And it just became worse with time. Well, I'll have to witness you get raped," he began to say. "I hope you get F-ked up by a gang of F-kers." He used racist slurs about the males "I would be or deserve to be abused by at times," she claimed in court. "I was worried he was going to murder me, either purposefully or by losing control and going too far. She punched, kicked, and slammed into me. She also threw heavy bottles, soda cans, blazing candles, television remotes, and pink thinner cans at my body and head on a frequent basis, wounding me gravely," Depp said in court documents, linked to a second libel petition lodged on May 2019. The Sun's claims against Depp were essentially genuine, according to a court on October 2020. On the other hand, the Pirates of the Caribbean star has insisted on an appeal on multiple occasions. Despite her harrowing testimony in London, Heard is seeking a silver lining, according to a person who spoke to us weekly recently. "She's been surrounding herself with loved ones and good friends she can trust and trying to do normal things like meet together and for supper safety," the source said, adding that the actress tried not to let the legal drama and hate get to her. Heard had announced 3 months prior that she had given birth to a surrogate daughter named Unog. More on Depp and Heard libel action can be found further down. Well, several celebrities with ties to Johnny Depp have come forward to defend him after his ex-wife Amber Heard accused him of domestic violence during their marriage. Vanessa Paradis, Depp's second ex-wife and mother of his two children, Winona Ryder, and his former co-star Penelope Cruz have all testified in his defense. It's worth noting that despite the fact that all three women claim Depp was never aggressive in their presence, only Depp and Heard are guaranteed to know the personal facts of Heard and Depp's marriage. Depp is suing Heard for alleged defamation that occurred when Heard publicly accused Depp of committing domestic violence against her during their marriage. People close to the Pirates of the Caribbean star are providing their testimony about their own experiences with him. Even after all these, it is very possible that he will still go to court. Why did Johnny Depp lose? Johnny Depp, an American actor, recently lost a libel claim he filed in London, accusing the newspaper The Sun of calling him a wife abuser, a reference to his relationship with ex-wife Amber Heard. It was a harrowing case that thrust both performers' personal lives into the spotlight. And it was a difficult case, with both parties accusing the other of abuse. Apart from the tabloid paper, there was an obvious winner: domestic violence victims. Let's start with the facts. Depp and Heard met when she was 22 and he was 4 to 5, and both were living with his longtime wife, Vanessa Paradis. Depp and Heard married years later but quickly divorced. Just before the divorce, Heard filed for a protection order, and photographers captured the mark on her face as she entered and left a Los Angeles court. Heard's claims that Depp had mistreated her verbally and physically while under the influence of narcotics and alcohol rapidly went viral. Depp has consistently denied the charges, alleging that Heard had actually abused him. The law comes next. The UK has a different libel law than the US. In summary, in the United States, the burden of proof for libel is on the person claiming to have been libeled, i.e., the plaintiff must establish that what has been written is false, at least in cases involving matters of public concern. The Sun had to prove that the material it published on Depp was truthful, since the burden of evidence in the United Kingdom is on the party accused of libel. The civil court's truth threshold was met in 12 of Heard's 14 complaints of abuse, according to the judge. Depp's attorneys have announced that they intend to appeal the decision. Heard is being sued by Depp as well. Depp isn't just on the wrong side of the law here, he's also lost the plot. The entire point of this lawsuit, supposedly, was to repair his reputation. And one can comprehend why Depp would want to clear his name if he is speaking the truth, and many admirers who gathered outside the courthouse and tweeted #justiceforjohnnydepp believe he is the genuine victim here. However, by filing multiple lawsuits, Depp is merely extending and expanding the coverage, reminding people of it, and bringing it to the attention of new people. He's not repairing his image, he's sullying it even more. And whether Depp is telling the facts or not, and a judge recently found that Heard's libel law stretches far beyond these two people, including tabloids' right to post whatever they want about superstars without fear of punishment. In the United Kingdom, persons can sue for libel and win if the people or entities they're suing can't prove their statements were false. Abusers with money can always threaten libel suits. Even if they lose, they may have destroyed the victim's financial resources and drive. Abusers with financial resources can always threaten libel actions in the United States and the United Kingdom. Even if they lose, they may have depleted the victim's financial means and resolve. This is a big challenge for survivors of domestic abuse, who often go to great lengths to conceal their abuse and don't always properly document every episode. Intimate partner violence is still underreported, stigmatized, and frequently disguised. The barriers to reporting it are already high, and most women who are assaulted by loved ones never speak up. The threat of a lawsuit, especially if the abuser has the financial means to sue, can add to the victim's worry. Those who are unfairly accused must, of course, face the penalty. It's inconvenient to have a damaging lie spread about you, particularly if you don't have millions in the bank. Bringing a lawsuit and establishing substantial harm, on the other hand, is difficult, especially in the United States, where ordinary people must prove that what is said about them is false. The American system provides for more freedom of speech, and survivors have more freedom to speak up, but this comes at a price. After all, the vast majority of defamation cases aren't about domestic violence, but rather about other potentially damaging allegedly false accusations. In this case, there isn't a perfect equilibrium. Libel laws in the United States may be too permissive, rendering it far too easy to spread false information about people, and far too difficult for anybody other than the affluent to fix the mistake. Furthermore, British regulations are overly conservative, placing an undue burden on media and individuals, especially those without the financial wherewithal to establish their claims in court. Regular individuals who are wounded, either by a phony claim or a genuine claim they can't verify, and have few options of the folks that lose out in both systems. Despite Johnny Depp's accusations that Hollywood is rejecting him, a Virginia judge recently ruled in his favor in his $50 million defamation lawsuit against Amber Heard. The judge concluded that because she was not named as a defendant, she was not subject to the same discovery procedures as named parties. In fact, respondent could not have been listed as a defendant in the UK case because her false and defamatory remarks were published after the UK action commenced, as court ruled, referring to Heard's December 2018 Washington Post op-ed, which spurred Depp to file a lawsuit shortly after. What are your thoughts on Johnny Depp and Amber Heard's relationship? Leave a comment below with your thoughts. Thank you very much for taking the time to look at my video. For the time being, that's all I have to say. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to the channel and set on post notifications to keep up with the latest lighted videos. Stay tuned and we'll see you in our next video.